In previous class, we are discussing about the concept of work. Now we are going to solve some problems from previous MCET examinations. So here is the problem I am taking, that find the work done by a person when the corresponding load of 30 kgs at a distance of 5 meters traveling vertically. This was the problem here. So first we need to, the thing is, what is the parameter we need to find out? So it is clearly stated that the work done, find the work done. So we need to find out work done. So here is the formula for work done is, work done equal to force into displacement into cos theta, the angle between the force and displacement, right? So after that, in the formula we have force here and displacement here. So second thing is, we need to find out the parameters from the problem. Here is the parameter, is load is 30 kgs and distance of 5 meters. So these are the two parameters, and the that doesn't mean the parameter is acceleration due to gravity 9.81. This is taken for the finding of force. So here we have load corresponding to conversion of force from the load is F equal to ma. We are taking the formula is F equal to ma. So we have the mass F equal to, mass is 30 kgs, value of 30, and a is, we are taking as acceleration due to gravity, the value of is 9.81 meter per second square. Okay, 9.81 meter per second square. Here is the acceleration. Okay, the value of force we need to take it from the formula. Okay, right. So here is the formula for F equal to ma, and after that we need to multiply with the displacement. Here it is, force into displacement to cos theta. So now write that force is here 30 into 9.81 into the displacement value is 5 meters. So 5 and cos theta. So what is the angle of theta? Here the moment is upwards traveling vertically, and acceleration is downwards. Acceleration due to gravity always acting downwards. Okay. So here is the angle between these two is 180 degrees. Is 180 degrees clearly. So now we will substitute the angle of 180 degrees into the cos angle. So what is the value of cos 180? That is minus 1. Okay. So now substitute the minus 1 to here, and force displacement cos angle of minus 1. Okay. So now the total multiplication of is 1471.5 and newtons into meters. So newton meter, 1 newton meter equal to 1 joules. So the units is joule, and the symbol of minus 1, multiplication 1 is the actual value, and we need to mention the minus 1. So here the minus symbol indicates, which means the work done opposes to the acceleration. That's why it comes minus symbol. So in previous class we are discussing about the symbol, that is, which is the displacement opposite to the force direction, we will give minus symbol, and which is corresponding to the force direction, we will give positive symbol. Okay. So here is opposite to the, here the force is acting this one, and displacement acting upward direction. So that's why the minus symbol will come. Alright, thank you. Okay students, coming to the second problem, we will take another direction. That is, now this problem is vertically. I'll mention that second problem, for the second problem is horizontally. What is it? Horizontally. Okay, just for the consideration of what is the motion of output motion. Okay, so the whole problem will be changed like this. The values are all same, but the problem is the direction is going to be changed horizontally. That means a person takes a load 30 kgs and he moves as a distance of 5 meters. He moves as a distance of 5 meters, and the force acts on downwards, and the displacement acts on rightwards. Okay. So now what is the angle between these two is 90 degrees. Let us consider free body diagram. Force is acting downwards 30 kgs, and displacement acts rightwards, that is 5 meters. And the angle between these two is 90 degrees. So what's the value of 90 degrees? Oh, that's the, we need to substitute after the cos angle. So let us consider work done equal to force into displacement into cos theta. So here the force, in previous class we have mentioned that force is 30 into acceleration, 9.81. Okay. And displacement is 5 meters. Right. And what is the value of cos theta? Cos 90 degrees. So the point is cos 90 degrees is 0. Cos 90 is 0. So what is the multiplication of 0? 0 into anything is 0. So totally work done is going to be 0. Because of the force acting in downwards and the motion coming from the force is acting right force. So there is no work done from the force. That's why the output is 0. Work done is totally 0. Here is the case 2, the horizontal motion. Okay? Right. Now the next problem is, a force of 25 newtons is applied on westward direction of a board is free to move in the northwest direction and moves through a distance of 11.31 meters. Find the work done. So, on the concept of western north direction, for that we will draw the north, east, west, south directions. Okay. So, primarily we will write the given data here. Given, what is the values? Here the low force, directly given by force. In previous problem, we convert the force from the load. But here the force is directly given, that is 25 newtons. 25 newtons. And the second thing is the distance here, 11.31 meters. So the second thing is distance. What's the value? 11.31 meters. Okay. So those two only. And the thing is, first the force applied on westward direction. See here the force applied on westward, from west onwards. Okay. This is one is the force, right? How much it is? 25 newtons. The force is 25 newtons. Okay. What is the reaction? And free to move in the northwest direction. So we need to, here it is the north direction and here it is the west direction. We need to find out northwest direction. Obviously it is 45 degrees to the in between north to west. Okay. So if you take it is a northwest direction, the reaction which is comes in the northwest direction and moves through the distance of 11.31. In the direction, the movement is 11.31 meters. That's the value. So, we need to observe the thing is, what is the angle between these two? In general, the angle between west and north is 90 degrees. So, exactly midpoint of 90 degrees, 45 degrees. 45 degrees. So we will find out the angle theta also. Theta equal to 45 degrees. So indirectly given the angle also. So what we need to find out is, now substitute the values in work done. Work done equal to force into displacement into cos theta. So what is the value of force? 25 newtons into displacement. What is the value of displacement here? 11.31, 25 into 11.31 into cos 45. So, by applying the angle of cos 45 value, finally we get approximately 199.91, exactly 199.91. So, work done, the value of work done is joules. 199, the units of work done is joules and the value is 199.91. So, approximately equal to 200 joules. Okay? You can multiply that in Casio, 25 into 11.3 into cos 45. Okay? Right. Thank you. Okay. The next problem is, the work done by a person in carrying a bag of mass 20 kgs at a vertical height of 5 meters is 4900 joules. Find the mass of the person. So, now onwards, we solve the problem as the final result of work done. But here is the work done is given. Here the work done is already given, that is 4900 joules. Once we read the problem, the work done by a person carrying a bag of mass 20 kgs at a vertical height of 5 meters is 4900 joules. He said clearly that work done is 4900 joules with the help of mass 20 kgs, that too bag only, not the person mass. And vertical height of 5 meters. And find the mass of the person. So, here is the problem is going to be little bit changed. So we need to find out the mass of the person, final result. So first we need to write given data. In given data, what are the parameters are there? First one is mass, M. What about it? 20 kgs. Okay. Then second one is vertical height, that is S. That is S. What about the value? 5 meters. Okay. Then also work done also is given onwards. Work done. How much it is? 4900 joules. Okay. So what we need to find out is find the mass of the person. Okay. So mass of the person is, let us consider it, the total mass is equal to capital M, which is mass of the person, plus small m, which is mass of the bag. This one is person mass and this one is bag mass. Okay, the total mass is mass of the person plus mass of the bag. So here substitute the value in the formula of work done. So work done equal to force into displacement into angle. So that's the one. Now replace with that mass, F equal to M into G into S. This is the formula. Now we have the values are there. Work done is 4900 joules, that is 4900, and mass in the sense mass equal to person mass plus bag mass. So we need to add M plus M. Simply write that M plus 20. Person is 20 kgs. Okay, bag is 20 kgs. Into 9.81. Into S value is 5 meters. Okay. So 9.81 into 5 is M plus 20. Into 49.05. Okay. 4900 is same. You don't need to write the joules. So again, convert the multiplication to left hand side, it will came as division. So 4900 by 49.05 equal to M plus 20. Now the 20 is added on the right hand side and it will come as subtract. So 49, simply we will write down the exactly mass equal to 4900 by 49.05 minus 20. Okay, so we need to find out mass exactly. The value is 79.8 kgs. So it is approximately 80 kgs. Therefore the value of the total mass is 80 kgs. Let us consider the total mass is 80 kgs and remove the 20 mass. The person mass is 60 kgs, that is capital M is 60 kgs and small m is 20 kgs, total 80 kgs. Okay, alright, that's the problem here.